Hey guys, welcome back to Mr. Canucks Grill. My name is Matt. If you're new to the channel, I do post every single Sunday, so don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you do like what you see. This week I have to move Edge over into the 5x5 with the new Electric Sky ES300, so I wanted to show you some of the training I did over the last week to increase canopy size. I typically use a combination of pulling down and tying branches and super cropping, but this time I split the stalks on the first two plants I tried to tie down, so instead I super cropped all the tallest branches down just by pinching and twisting the stems. Now that the plants have been super cropped, I'm gonna go ahead and give them some dechlorinated tap water, pH to 6.8. Then give them a couple days to recover before moving them on over into the 5x5 grow tent. So here's the three new freshly installed ES300s from the Green Sunshine Company. These units are 300 true watts each, and they now come with dimming capabilities, which I'll get to in a second. I still haven't brought Veg on over, so let's go get that done. Since it is winter, I do like to raise the pots off the cold ground. This is a very simple and effective way to keep the plant's root system in an ideal temperature zone to help with optimized growth. If the root zone is too cold, the plants will experience slowed growth and become stunted. In case you were wondering, I have 3 OG Kush and 3 Amherst Sour Diesel from Humboldt Seed Organization, which I am pheno hunting for the best of each one. I'm looking for vigorous growth, high resin production, and unique terpene and flavonoid profile out of each strain. I will clone each plant before sending in the flower, then choosing which pheno of each strain becomes the permanent mom to keep and clone off. This will help with quality and ensure consistency from grow to grow. I went ahead and hooked up the wattage meter to the ES300s to see how much watts they were pulling, and to get them adjusted down to 600 true watts because, well, we're in veg and we just don't need all that power just yet. So we got those adjusted, then hooked the timers back up and set them to 18.6 to continue the veg cycle, because we still have a couple more weeks to go of filling this canopy out before flipping these girls into flower. Today I'm re-amending the mediums of each plant. I like to use Gaia Green Organic Dry Amendments, which is slow time release fertilizer. The last time I had to re-amend the mediums was 4 weeks ago when I transplanted into 3-gallon pots. Since then, I've simply just watered when dry, pH between 6.5 and 6.8. To amend medium, I'm top dressing using 6 tablespoons of Gaia Green all purpose for this 3-gallon pot, and I'm mulching it in with the topsoil and watering in slowly with water pH to 6.5. Now that it's been over a week since training the plants, you can kind of begin seeing the results. The plants are growing wider and creating more coleocytes, which is helping to fill out this 5x5 grow space. The plants are doing great under the electric sky set to 600 watts of power. I figured it'd be another 2 weeks around before flipping to the flower schedule. At that time, I plan on increasing the power draw by 50 watts or so each week until the middle of flower. The average temperature during lights on has been around 75 degrees Fahrenheit with an average RH of 45%. The AC unit is still hooked up but seems to only come on once or twice when the dehumidifier is going on. It is the start of winter and is getting colder and colder every day, so I'm not sure if I'll need to rely on the AC once I start using more watts out of the Electric Sky ES300s. Now for a quick update, in the ES300 closet grow, it's the end of week 4 flower and the canopy is filling back in nicely from the early flower defoliation we did during week 2. As usual, Harley is close by hanging out, but let's take a closer look at all of the flowers we have in this garden. So side by side, I have the Sativa Dominant LSD and Indica Dominant Critical Kush from Barney's Farm. I have a beautiful GDP cut which has some great resin production, some big stack colas, and there's some purpling happening on the outside edges of the fan leaves. I have three clones of my prized Fino Girl Scout Cookie Cut which turns full purple and a flower, and you can already see the fan leaves turning colors. I'm overly excited for this heavy hitter Indica. I also have one Chocolate Mint OG and one Black Dog from Humboldt Seed Organization, which are looking the hungriest out of the bunch. They have been top dressed, so hopefully they green up a little more in the next couple weeks, but overall, I'm happy with the variety of strains in this 8x2 closet as we approach week 5 of flower. Hey, I just want to say thank you so much for taking time out of your day to watch this video. Do want to remind you though that links to everything you see in this video are down below in the description, including the coupon codes. And don't forget though, I will be here next week, so hit that subscribe button if you're not already. And you're looking to help the channel grow, simply leave a like, drop a question down below, because those two things dramatically help the channel. Other than that, you have a great week. Catch you later.